गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, आई एम खुशी कुमारी, अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ क्लास 12 कॉमर्स. टुडे आई एम हियर टू रिसाइट अ पोएम कीपिंग क्वाइट विच इज़ रिटन बाय पैब्लो नेरुडा. नाउ वी विल काउंट टू 12 एंड वी विल ऑल कीप स्टिल फॉर वंस ऑन द फेस ऑफ द अर्थ. लेट्स नॉट स्पीक इन एनी लैंग्वेज. लेट्स स्टॉप फॉर 1 सेकेंड एंड नॉट मूव आवर आर्म्स सो मच. इट विल बी एन एग्जॉटिक मोमेंट विदाउट रश विदाउट इंजन्स. थैंक यू.
I am Sanjana of class 12. Today I want to recite a poem, Aunt Jennifer's Tiger, written by Adrienne Rich. Aunt Jennifer's Tiger prance across the screen, bright denizens topaz of a world of green. They never fear the man beneath the tree, they pace in sleek, chivalric certainty. Aunt Jennifer's finger fluttering through her wool, find even ivory needle hard to pull. The massive weight of uncle's wedding band sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hand. When aunt will die, her terrifying hand will lie, still ring with ordeals she was mastered by. The tiger in the panel that she made will go on prancing proud and unafraid.
I, Dishant Bokan of class 12th arts, I'm gonna speak on my mother at 66. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me, doze open-mouthed, her face ashen like that of a corpse, and realized with pain that she thought away and looked, but soon put that thought away and looked out at young trees sprinting, the merry children spilling out of their homes, but after the airport security checks standing a few yards away, I looked again at her wan, pale as a late winter's moon, and felt that old familiar ache, my childhood fear. But all I said was, see you soon, Amma. All I did was smile, smile, smile. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Myself first. Today I am going to recite a poem, A Things of Beauty. A things of beauty is a joy forever. A loving bliss increases. It will never pass into the nothingness, but will keep a brows quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams, and health and a quiet breathing. Therefore, on every morrow are we wreathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Thank you.
Good morning, teachers and my dear friend. My name is Preeti Sharma. I am from class 12th arts, and today I am going to recite you a poem called Elementary School. Far, far from gusty waves, these children's faces like rootless weeds, the tall girl with the weighted down head, the paper-seeming boy with red eyes, the stunted unlucky hair of twisted bones, reciting of father grand diseases, his lesson from his desk, a back in class, one unnoted sweet and young, his eyes lives in a dream of squirrels came, in grey room other than this, a sour cream walls, donations Shakespeare had, cloudless at dawn, civilized storm, hiding of cities.
Good morning, everyone. Myself, Azad Singh. And today I am going to recite a poem, An Elementary School Classroom in Aslam. Far gulty waves with children, faces like rootless weeds, the hair turned round their polar, the tall girl with her weighed down head, the paper seeming boys with red eyes, the stunned unlucky hair of twisted bones, resetting father's this is his lesson from his desk at back of the dim.
Hi, my name is Anup Kumar, and today I am going to recite a poem, and the title of my poem is Aunt Jennifer's Tiger, and the poet's name is Adrienne Rich. Aunt Jennifer's tigers prance across a screen, bright topaz denizens of a world of green. They do not fear the man beneath the tree, they pace in sleek chivalry certainty. Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttering through her wool find even the ivory needle hard to pull. The massive weight of uncle's wedding band sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hand. When aunt is dead, her terrified hands will lie still ringed with ordeals she was mastered by. The tigers in the panel that she made will go on prancing proud and unafraid. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Myself, Aryan, and I'm reading in class 12th in CD International School. Today's my topic is My Mother at 69. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me, does open-mouthed, her face ashen like that of corpse, and realized with pain that she was an old, as she was looked but soon. Put that thought away and look at young trees sprinting, the merry children spilling out of her homes, but after the airport's security check, standing a few hours away, I looked at again at her warm pale as a late winter's moon and felt that old, familiar ache, my childhood's fear. But all I said was, see you soon, Amma. All I did was smile, smile and smile.
Hello everyone, my name is Suhani and I am a student of class 12th. I am going to recite the poem A Thing of Beauty by John Keats. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. Therefore, on every morrow are we writhing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Spite of despondence, of the inhuman dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over-darkened ways, made for our searching, yes, in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall. From our dark spirits, such as the sun, the moon, trees, old and young, sprouting a shady bloom.
Good morning, I am Sahil Yadav of class 12. Today I am going to speak on topic My Mother at 66. Driving from my parents' home to Cochin, last Friday morning, I saw my mother beside me, doors open-mounted, her face ashen like that of a corpse, and realized with pain that she was as old as she looked but soon. Put that thought away and looked out at young trees spreading, the merry children spiling out of their home, but the airport checking, standing a few yards away.